Shalom Israel, I'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem Rakakwadash, the Buanas, the Apostle, the Elders of Great Millstone, and Shalom to the Lek out there, doing this work of faith and labor of love and true sincerity. All right, and I wanted to get into a brief topic. I believe I call it idolatry at its finest, you know, or the golden calf of New York City, you know, and, you know, brothers, a couple brothers and a brother in my camp, you know, did a lesson on this, you know, months back. But I wanted to touch on it, being as though, you know, me and a few brothers from my camp, you know, were literally out there, you know, in New York City around this area, you know, to check out, you know, the museum, and live and direct, and lo and behold, should I say, you have these people out there worshiping, you know, pretty much this damn charging bull, man. You know, and this is truly nothing but idolatry at its finest, you know. People coming from all over different parts of the globe, you know, to touch this damn bull and to take a picture of them holding the balls of the bull, which is utter and complete madness, man. You know, and this lets you know, and what this was, an Edomite that created this bull. All right, and I'll read this brief thing. Okay, this is it was created by Arturo de Modica. Okay, that's his name. He's an Italian guy, so-called Italian guy. It says, Arturo de Modica first conceived of the charging bull as a way to celebrate the can-do spirit of America, and especially New York, where people from all over the world could come regardless of their origin or circumstances, and through determination and hard work overcome every obstacle to become successful. Is this symbol of virility and courage that Arturo saw as the perfect antidote to the Wall Street crash of 1986. All right, so I won't read no more on that, but so this guy created this in so-called representation, you know, of overcoming, you know, the hard work and every obstacle to become successful, you know. In which, you know, people that come to this country, they call it the American dream, you know. But to us, it's a fucking nightmare, man. Nothing but a nightmare, okay? Esau's heaven is our hell, all right? And with this, you truly, as you brothers can see, you know, people, you know, we didn't stay at that one spot that long, but you can see from the footage, you know what I'm saying? I'm just looping it. These people are really fucking insane, man. And this is nothing but the golden calf, you know what I'm saying? When Israel was worshiping the golden calf, you know? And I saw one article that called it the golden calf of New York City, man. All right? And I didn't happen to see any Jakes over there, but I'm pretty sure you have some jicks over there that be doing that shit too, man. All of this stuff is for Esau, these Edomites, and all these other nations to be into heavily, but not our people, man. You know, and in the kingdom, you know, all of this is going to change. We know, you know what I'm saying, these heathen, they not going to be worshiping their false entities, their false deities that they're worshiping now. You know, the Most High Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah is going to put a stop to all of that, man. You know, but stuff like this is, it just goes to show you the utter idiocy of people that's out there. What is so fascinating about going to this place to see a damn bull and to touch the bull's balls, man, and to take a picture there, all right? It's nothing but idolatry, man. Let me just get into the scriptures real quick, all right? This is 1 Corinthians 10 and 14, and it says, you know, and this is pertaining to our people, because you still have our people, you know, that are into different false, you know, religions and all that anyway. And religion is, you know, nothing but he saw his creation any goddamn way, you know, to divide and conquer, you know. But have many of our people too, like heavy into Islam and going over there to Mecca and, you know, worshiping the Kaaba stone and all that. All this different stuff is idolatry, man. You know, all of it. Any of our people that's into any other thing except Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, it's nothing but idolatry, man. You know? All right, so this 1 Corinthians 10 and 14, it says, wherefore, my dearly beloved, flee from idolatry. Okay, I'll just continue on. It says, I speak as to wise men, judge ye what I say. You know, I'm going to jump down to verse 18, because the Lord is always talking to his people, you know. And he gives a direct reference, verse 18, behold, Israel after the flesh, you know. So many people claim that, you know, the Gentiles, this, that, and the third. But the Lord is only dealing with Israel, and the Lord only speaks directly with Israel, man, you know. Okay, that's how it rolls, man. So behold, Israel after the flesh, and the Israel after the flesh is still here, you know. But it's more so, we are Israel in the flesh, but it's all about the spirit, man, you know. It says, behold, Israel after the flesh, are not they which eat of the sacrifices, partakers of the altar? What say I then, that the idol is anything, or that which is offered in sacrifice to idols is anything? You know, those offerings in which we used to do for the Lord, we knew, you know what I'm saying, that was true offerings, because we know that we serve a power that actually is living, the power that rules and governs this world. Okay, so what Paul is saying is like, yo, so what should I say then? The things that you know, that sacrifice unto the idols, is that really something? No, it's not anything. So all of these people that's out there doing these type of things, they're doing nothing but wasting their goddamn time, man. They may not see it as worship, but that's what it truly is. There's nothing else to be said about it. It's paganistic idol worshiping, you know? And I guarantee you it's some of our people, you know what I'm saying, that's out there that be doing it too, man, you know? Verse 20, but it says, but I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to devils and not to Yahweh. And I would not that ye should have fellowship with devils. So, you know, everything in which they doing, man, it's nothing but pure evil. You know, it's no in the middle. It's only two sides to the coin, man. Righteousness or wickedness, and everything in which they do is wickedness, man. You know, and this, and just thinking about it, and you know, like in Jeremiah 44, you know, our people love to be in wickedness regardless, and they don't choose to follow after their righteous power, man. You know? So, and spiritually, even though you may not have, you know, a lot of our people that's out there physically doing that, but spiritually they are doing that, man. You know, because they're into this society, they're into this world. They worship the things of the world. Money is a god unto them, you know? So, and spiritually, they bring in all of this stuff back. All this stuff is here all over again, you know, as we know, right? And they don't want to go off of that path, because they can't see a life without that, you know, without their trinkets, without their, you know, their Esau riches, man, you know? They can't see a life without it, because our people have been struggling so long, so they see, like, yo, this is the only way for me. Nah, the scriptures is the only way, man. But our people constantly fall into the trap, right? So this is Jeremiah 44 in verse 18, and it says, matter of fact, I started at verse 16, and it says, as for the word that thou hast spoken unto us in the name of the Lord, we will not hearken unto thee. So this is what our people are doing, man. You know, we're telling them about themselves, telling them about their wickedness. You know, the other nations, they're hearing the message, but of course they're not going to get it until the shit is too late, you know. By then they're going to be in slavery and shackled down, man, you know. So they hearing the message because they got to hear that judgment, all right. And that judgment is going to be for all their atrocities in which they committed unto us, You know, and they're going to have to serve our power according to Zechariah, the 14th chapter, man. You know, verse 17, it says, but we will certainly do whatsoever thing go forth out of our own mouth to burn incense unto the queen of heaven and to pour out drink offerings unto her, as we have done, we and our fathers, our kings and our princes in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem. For then had we plenty of victuals and were well and saw no evil. But since we left off to burn incense to the queen of heaven and to pour out drink offerings unto her, we have wanted all things and have been consumed by the sword and by the famine. Okay? So this is exactly how our people think. If I don't do this, I'm going to be suffering. So I have to continue to keep sacrificing my time, my energy, and all of this to the ways of the so-called white man if I want to make it. Because other than that, what, I'm going to starve. You know what I'm saying? My kids not going to eat. You don't have to do wickedness in order to take care of what you got to do. You know, our people truly don't see that it's light at the end of the tunnel, so to speak, man. You know, and that light is Yahweh and his son Yahweh Shah, man. You know? But what we seen when we actually went down there, like I said, I know brothers did, you know, vids on this before, but to actually go down there and to witness it, man, that shit was disgusting, man. You know, I got what I could of it and then stepped off because that shit was horrible to see people out there doing that shit. But that's the way of the heathen. So, you know, it is what it is. But for our people, our ways is Yahweh and the son Yahweh Shah. And nothing else, man, you know? And that was truly, truly idolatry at its finest, man. That's his best state as far as I've seen it, you know, with my two eyes. You know, so, you know, with that, you know, I hope this short segment was edifying. And I'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim Rakakwadash, Dabuana to the apostles and elders of great millstone, and Shalom to the elect out there, doing his work of faith, labor of love, and true sincerity. Shalom.